I'm Brittany Gashy, and I had to read Street Level Bureaucracy: The Critical Role of Street Level Bureaucrats. So here is my presentation. In the reading, it talks about the discretionary actions of public employees being benefits and sanctions of government programs and being used to determine access to government rights and benefits. Most citizens encounter government through street level bureaucrats such as teachers, policemen, social workers, judges, public lawyers, and health workers. Public agencies that employ a significant number of street level bureaucrats are considered street level bureaucracies. The way street level bureaucrats deliver services structures people's lives and opportunities and provides the context in which people act. Every extension of service benefits has some degree of state control. That said, street level bureaucrats are constantly torn by the demands to improve services and the demands to improve efficacy and government efficiency. So they're torn between state control and the constituents that they serve. One topic that the reading covered was controversies. Street level bureaucrats dominate political controversies for a few reasons. First, debates about the proper scope and focus of governmental services are essentially debates over the scope and function of these public employees. Street level bureaucrats also have considerable impact on people's lives. They socialize citizens, so think about police officers interacting with citizens. Social workers also interact with citizens, teachers. They determine eligibility of citizens for government benefits, and social workers. They will approve or deny who is eligible for those benefits. They oversee the treatment citizens receive in those programs and many other examples. Street level bureaucrats also tend to be the focus of public controversy because they must be dealt with if policy is to change. So think about if policy changes from the top down, that it has to trickle down to those street level bureaucrats. They also are the focus of public controversy because they represent the immediate interactions with citizens and their impact on people's lives. So they are pretty much the first line that people see. Another topic that was brought up in this reading was the employment of street level bureaucrats. So state and local governments employ approximately 3.7 million employees in local schools, over 500,000 in police operations, and more than 300,000 in public welfare. A measure of the significance of street level bureaucrats in the public sector employment is the amount of funds allocated to pay for them. So in public government, of course, the most expensive piece of their budget is for salaries. So of all local government salaries, more than half went to public education. This statistic was from 1973, so it might be different as of now. I didn't have the chance to look it up for 2017, but in the text it says in 1973, more than half went to public education. So about 80% was used to pay instructional personnel, and about one-sixth of the local public salaries that was not allocated to public education was allocated to police. So that is one-sixth of whatever was left after public education. The text also says from 1955 to 1975, government employment more than doubled because of the baby boom and the growing number of elderly dependent citizens. Street level bureaucracies are labor intensive because their operation is providing service through people, and the operating costs of such agencies reflect their dependence on salaried workers. So, take for example the city of Savannah, for whom I work, and think about their budget. A lot of that budget goes to public safety, and most of that budget for public safety is police officer salary and lieutenant salary and sergeants and captains, and you get the idea. So the biggest expenditure is for salaried workers, and that kind of is reflective of the reliance on those street level bureaucrats. So something else that came up in the text were social considerations. Charity was once the responsibility of private agencies. However, the federal government now provides for the income needs of the poor, and the public sector has absorbed responsibilities such as policing, education, and health. The poorer people are, the greater the influence street-level bureaucrats have over them. So again, I'm going to use the police officer anecdote. So if somebody is confronted by a police officer, the police officer may have more leverage over them if they are poorer. Think again about social workers. If they see an application for somebody who is poorer, that social worker has more influence over them to either approve or deny their request for public benefits. Social reformers who seek to ameliorate the problems of the poor often bring up the status of street-level bureaucrats. So are poor people deprived of equal access to courts? Provide them with lawyers. Do the poor people have access to health care? Establish neighborhood clinics. Public employees have benefited from the increase in public spending on street-level bureaucracies. This is to make it look more desirable to work for the public governments and public agencies. Salaries have increased considerably. Public employees have a more secure control over their work environments because they have established unions and union-like associations. So the text kind of talked about teachers' unions and how they are able to kind of band together and request work environments and have more control over their work environments because they have power in numbers, basically. So where they're able to kind of unionize, they are able to gain more control over their work environments. How street-level bureaucrats affect people. So decisions of street-level bureaucrats are redistributive and allocative. Those are two terms that were used in the text. So in determining eligibility for benefits, they enhance the claims of some citizens, meaning they'll approve those or move them up the chain of approval. They do that at the expense of taxpayers who pay for those benefits and those claims that are denied. So if somebody is approved, that means that somebody else is denied. So those types of street-level bureaucrats have more impact on citizens in that way. Street-level bureaucrats make decisions about people that may affect their life chances. To designate someone as a welfare recipient, juvenile delinquent, or high achiever affects the relationships of others and that person's self-evaluation. These designations also have the tendency to perpetuate self-fulfilling prophecies. So, for example, if a teacher labels a student as someone who is a juvenile delinquent or someone who needs maybe some extra help or and needs to be put in a decelerated type of class, that might perpetuate the self-fulfilling prophecy that that person will be a juvenile delinquent or in need of a decelerated class for a long time because that person is now surrounded by people who are like that. Street-level bureaucrats and communities. The nature of government service delivery through street-level bureaucrats helps explain why street-level bureaucracies are currently the primary focus of community conflict. Two preconditions for successful community reorganization efforts: hope and plausibility that individual benefits may accrue to those taking part in group action, visible, accessible, and blamable collective target. Communities often place blame on street-level bureaucrats because they are visible and are their first interaction with government and policy. So again, think of the police officer on the street, think of the teacher, think of the social worker. Citizens also hold street-level bureaucrats responsible for maintaining and/or correcting their way of life. For example, if a neighborhood is experiencing a series of break-ins, citizens will expect police officers to step in and help. If a mother's son is failing in school, she will expect the teacher to help her son succeed. Street-level bureaucrats represent the hopes of citizens for fair and effective treatment by government, even as they are positioned to see clearly the limitations on effective intervention and the constraints on responsiveness engendered by mass processing.